We already have in the stable channel the third Flutter release of the year, Flutter 3.13, loaded with numerous enhancements including improvements in the new Impeller graphics renderer. We have now a preview for macOS, advances with the Vulkan backend for Android and performance improvements for iOS. This release also includes new properties and features for some widgets such as text recognition for text field on iOS, the ability to adapt alert dialog for Android and iOS, and much more. Stick with me because I'm going to give you a hyper quick tour of the most notable new features in this new Flutter 3.13. Let's start by talking about Impeller, the new graphics renderer for Flutter, which was established as the default renderer for iOS in the latest version. In this new version 3.13, we can already enjoy Impeller in preview mode for macOS. In fact, it is already possible to download the Wanderos application from the App Store on Mac, which is what you are seeing on the screen right now. In any case, you have to remember that it is a preview and that it's not yet stable for use in production on macOS. If you want to browse this application yourself, I will leave you the link for this app in the description of the video. Continuing with Impeller, the official blog post details how the Flutter team and their contributors have further improved performance on iOS, so we should be able to see even better performance in our apps when running on iOS. The work on the Vulkan backend, which is the one that works on Android, is still ongoing, although we will probably still have to wait until the end of the year to be able to enjoy a preview on Android. Let's now see what's new in the framework, starting with the ability to recognize text using OCR in text field for iOS. I have tried this feature and the truth is that it is quite interesting. As you can see, now an icon appears automatically through which we can open the camera and scan text from the real world. I get the feeling that this is a native iOS feature that has been integrated into the text field. I'm not entirely sure because I'm not an iOS user, so if I'm saying something wrong, please correct me in the comments. Another quite interesting change is that Alert Dialog now has an adaptive constructor. What does this mean? Well, by means of this new constructor, we will be able to show a dialog in the material style or in the Cupertino style automatically. We also now have the possibility of showing a Cupertino date picker to select only the month and the year, setting the mode to month-year as you can see in this example. In addition to the above, we also have improvements in Cupertino radio, more customizations in the material widgets such as tooltips in button segment, or customizing the gap in expansion panel list. Of course, I leave the link to the official blog post in the video description in case you want to see the details of the rest of the improvements. Another important aspect of this release is the work to adapt to the next versions of their respective operating systems that Flutter supports. As for Android, this new version supports Android 14, and although some new improvements still need to be implemented, the Flutter team informs us that the most important bugs in this new version have already been resolved. Flutter 3.13 also correctly supports iOS 17 and Xcode 15. Those users who want to target this new version will have to use Flutter 3.13. We also have improvements for iOS in reducing the distortion that occurs when going from portrait to landscape and vice versa, and the possibility of renaming the runner project that Flutter automatically creates for Apple platforms. To finish this summary of improvements, I would like to comment on some important changes that I think we should take into account. First of all, Material 3 is scheduled to be the default mode in the next stable version of Flutter. I remind you that you have an online demo that you can see in your browser with all the Material 3 widgets so you can see how they look. I leave the link in the description. In addition, this new version also incorporates new APIs to work with foldable devices. If you are interested in developing for this type of devices, I suggest you look at the details of these new changes to know how they can help you. We also have improvements to the Flutter Casual Games Toolkit, a resource pack aimed at developing games with Flutter. Now you can enjoy more video resources and examples if you are interested in using Flutter to develop your next game. Those are the improvements that I like the most in Flutter 3.13. If you are interested in seeing the rest of the improvements or going deeper into those already mentioned, I will leave you the link to the official blog post in the video description. If you like this video, leave me a good like. And if you want to see more content about Flutter, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for staying with me until the end. I wish you a beautiful rest of your day. Goodbye.